Good morning. Hi, everybody. We are in Puerto Rico. This is our first official day. Last night, we were traveling all day. I'm at the resort. We will be here for 12 days. I'm actually trying to find where is the fitness center. So I am happy to be sharing this vlog with you guys.
We stayed at the Hyatt Regency. Overall, I was pretty happy with the resort. They had a gym. They had a lot of amenities. They also gave you water every day, which was a plus.
They got a Marshall's in Puerto Rico, Home Depot, Church's Chicken, Macaroni Grill.
We head down to the Old San Juan area of Puerto Rico. They have this like pigeon plaza where a lot of pigeons hang out. You can feed them. They literally fly all over you. It's kind of fun. A lot of people were having fun with the pigeons feeding them, but they will poop on you, just to let you know. This was also the golf course by the resort.
We are at the bar. It is super boring.
The weather out here is very unpredictable, so expect rain all the time. I think it's rained like twice since we've been here. But I mean, considering Puerto Rico isn't a rainforest, it makes sense, right?
If you go to Puerto Rico, you have to get a rental car. You have to. No Ubers, no taxis, rent a car.
We are day two, waiting to eat at a restaurant. I will put the restaurant name in the show notes, but it has like 5-star rating on Yelp. So, you know, if it's Yelp approved, we have to try it.
One of the pools is called the quiet pool because it is one level, and then the second pool I think is just a smaller version, but this is the main pool. There's a bar, they do activities, blah blah blah, yada yada. So we're gonna get some drinks, enjoy ourselves, and hang out. Day two. It's got a little nice couch seating area. TV. No microwave. This is the mini fridge. This is our view. Our patio. Haven't really spent much time out there.
Yeah,
we're walking to go get something to eat. Probably gonna drive. And then also, we're getting our daughter and her boyfriend, so I'm excited about that. Okay. My husband is super annoying. He annoys me every time I'm trying to record something. Oh my god, men are annoying. Those are the conky frogs. I think it's speakers. I don't know. It just is really loud in only one section. Would the frogs be everywhere? I mean, that's me, but you know, I roll off of conspiracies. Oh, look, there's one right there. Let me see. Oh, there's.
You don't know shit.
You don't know shit.
They're everywhere. The frogs are everywhere. I guess. They just live in the bush. They like to be by the water.
Okay.
This ends up one of my favorite restaurants of the whole stay. I'm definitely going to put it in the show notes and you'll see it multiple times. It's a new day. We wanted to go to the waterfalls, but unfortunately you need to have reservations for your car. So this time we actually went to the little exploratorium and nature center that is right before the waterfalls. This area, you do not need a reservation. But if you are planning on seeing their waterfalls, I highly suggest you check it out and make your reservations.
I'm good.
So you don't have to do two multiple trips. But this area had birds, facts about nature, and it also had two hiking trails.
We are at the rainforest today. Well, we're at the park because the rainforest section you need reservations, so we'll probably come back. There's lots of lizards. Lizards everywhere. Lizards.
I feel like that day I literally walked so much. I must have walked at least, I don't know, 6 miles, 10 miles between the two forts. But it was amazing. Great time. Super windy out there when we went. We ended up back at the hotel hanging out for the night and then getting something to eat at one of the local little restaurant takeout areas. It was so good. I got an empanada and some Puerto Rican rice. The next day we are here with our tour guide at one of the local beaches and caves.
I don't remember where it is, but they go...
When I say you feel it until it's already dragging you, it's just like that. Once I was surfing, when I like fell into the deep part, my body went sideways and I just got dragged out to the side like this quick. That was the first time I was really scared. I was in my third person. I was able to get off of it quick, but if it was like a person swimming, I've seen way, way, way smaller. When I say smaller, like just like a little speck of a snail.
He dropped. Oh, he's right there.
And then the biggest one, like this big.
this high up, so this is kind of freaking me out a little bit. But I guess I'm for fun.
360 degrees. Ridiculous,
really. You don't see it from here, but that's where we're going.
So our tour guide took some of the younger and better physically equipped people down to the bottom of the cave by the ocean. Apparently, there's some area where you have to crawl. It's super narrow and looks really dark and scary. As you see, Ignacio is climbing out after they finish their little trip down. My daughter did say she thought it was a little scary, but overall it was doable for somebody like her. She also works out every day and eats pretty good, and she's basically almost 80 pounds thinner than me. So this was not the adventure for me, but they had a great time.
I saw the video, like...
We ended our tour by seeing the rest of the ocean and doing some walking. Then we went to a restaurant that our tour guide recommend and takes his guests to. It was super good. I got a pina colada that was so delicious, and some fish tacos with crab. And then we ended up going to another beach. This beach was beautiful. It was super clear and overall amazing. New day. We hiked up this tower, as you can hear me heavy breathing. I would say I've done a lot of hiking on this trip. We were planning on going to the rainforest and the waterfalls, and this is our adventure. So everybody who knows me already knows that hiking and uphills are very hard for me. A lot of it has to do with my heart condition and the fact that I'm a little bit, let's just say, fluffy size. But besides that, it was worth it.
The orchids just growing on the palm trees.
We had an amazing time at the waterfalls, but it was a long day for us. So after the waterfalls, it was time for us to go and get ready and go home to the hotel and get ready to go to the Bacardi factory, or also known as Bacardi factory.
Sourcing the molasses from top producers around the world, like Guatemala and the Dominican Republic. And now, everybody, to the right-hand side, you can see the huge bright blue tanks. This is the very beginning of our production line. Those are fermentation tanks.
And to recall those you're going to find all over the Spanish Caribbean. And here, I want to talk to you all about three major events that led... As you were able to see in the movie, Havana Bar was our representation of style, an iconic place, and Bacardi was always at the forefront of innovation. So I'd like to proceed. That's our Bacardi special served with Ente, our exclusive house rum. Friends, this blend of rums is from 8 and up to 12 years.
Waterfalls and the Bacardi factory are an absolute must for your trip to Puerto Rico. I would definitely put that on the to-do list.
Just walking around.
I will give you my honest opinion about the food at the resort. It was not that good. We actually most of the time ate outside of the resort, and rarely do we eat at the resort. That's just my personal opinion. In the city of Ponce, and we are doing the tour of the Don Q Museum slash looks like mansion.
Thank you.
The houses, like, literally, some of them look like they're on the edge of the mountain. Like, all it needs is a good rain, and it could fall off. I think I'd be a little nervous. But they're all built out of cement. Super pretty. I mean, I would live in the rainforest. And of course, it is the rainforest, so it's starting to rain. That is expected. I think it's almost like because we're so high up. All right, now we gotta turn around. Guys, we were like literally in the middle of the rainforest, and there's the McDonald's. So I think this is more kind of like where the town is. But McDonald's does not quit. Like, they just show up in all locations. We actually went to a McDonald's. There's a dispensary right there for all the 420 lovers. We actually went to one, and it was pretty like just like in the States. I actually thought it tasted a little better. It's probably fresher ingredients. The fries were not as salty, though, I will say. I'm used to like hella sodium from the McDonald's fries, but it was good. I got the Big Mac meal. So this must be more kind of like where the town is, because there's a little shops, Bacardi bar. Let's see. So we're going to either a restaurant or a little food area, food truck. Everyone loves free. So I will say that all the roads are super narrow and like windy, which people should be driving slowly, but you know, I'm sure the locals are kind of used to it, so they're just like trying to get where they gotta go. Bumpy speed bump. We're about 5 minutes away. Supposedly this restaurant's owned by a guy who still works there that's like 92 years old, and he has really good food, so that's why we're headed out there. I mean, we've been driving for like almost an hour from the hotel, the resort, which is down closer by the San Juan area. Now it's like really pouring. We're like super high up in the mountains. Oh. So we made it. Paradise. I think this is the legend. Hola! Hey, our man can start feeding me. It's like a lot of sausage.
chorizo. So unfortunately, they're not serving food today, but tomorrow, but they give us some sausage. Super good. Look at the plants. Oh my gosh, I could go crazy.
It's coming.
Well, that kind of sucks because they're closed, but I'm going somewhere. Get some food. There's all kinds of little restaurants kind of on the way. This is where we are. I think my favorite part about the trip is the food. It's so freaking good. Like every place, it's fresh. It is amazing. I absolutely love the vibe of Puerto Rico and everything about it. The culture, the people, everybody's so nice. It's so inviting and you just love spending your time there. One of the things that I did do was overpack. I packed so many clothes, it was kind of ridiculous. In all honesty, what I used and wore the most were basically tank tops and shorts. I did use a variety of shorts, biker shorts, denim shorts, running shorts. Sometimes I would wear a dress, but overall, yeah, it was pretty much an active wear. I hated carrying around my purse, so I did bring one of my fanny packs, which is a must, a fanny pack or a backpack.
Good morning. This is our little patio view. Getting ready to start the day. These are our little chairs in case we want to come out, drink some coffee, and enjoy the view. After a long day of walking, we're gonna come back to one of the bars that are right, it's like a bar and restaurant, and it's right on the water in San Juan, and get pina coladas. I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like. It has a pink exterior. It's called La Casita, and it's in Old San Juan. This is our second time being here, and super cute. This is our first time trying the food. The last time we just basically got drinks, but now we're actually going to see what the food is all about, and I'll show you guys what we ordered when it gets here. So this is what we got. We both got the sliders and the Puerto Rican rice. Louis asked me what I was going to get, and I said sliders, and he basically
copied me because that's how he rolls. But anyways, it looks amazing. Okay, the sliders, I'm going to say they were pretty good. Give them like 8 out of 5. but they get you full quick. The rice, definitely was like a 10 out of 10. That shit was bomb. Hella good. I had to order another sexy colada. Louis making fun of me. He got a Bacardi and Coke and lime, Cubano Libre or whatever they call it. Sexy colada, they put an extra shot in it. They put a Bacardi back or Bacardi back. So I'm going to say if you're going to Puerto Rico, you have to put this place on the list of places to eat and drink. We are at the bar at the hotel because we have to watch the Lakers game because the Lakers are in the playoffs against Denver. And for those who don't know, my husband is a huge Lakers fan. Like, so big of a Lakers fan. But this is kind of like their bar/entertainment center at the Hyatt. They have somebody who like is a DJ. They're usually here on the weekends and most of the weekdays too. I noticed they have some type of entertainment and they play like either karaoke. But this is our last weekend here and then we'll be heading back to the States. I would say I love it here, but I am kind of ready to go home and see my dog. I miss Bruno and I miss Tank and I miss my kids, even though my daughter was out here, but I haven't been able to see my son. So I'm kind of starting to get ready to, you know, go home. All right, so let's watch this Laker game and go Lakers. Good morning, it is Sunday and we are getting ready to go to a festival in one of the neighboring towns or cities. So I'm gonna take you guys. I'm not trying to go back to eating church and chicken. It's a nice day, I'm sipping tea and I'm reading. If she brings
una proclama.
the beach.
This is the other pool. It's a little smaller. This one only has one height. I think it's like 4 feet. So they say like a lot of kids come here, but it's called the quiet pool. That's what they call it.
Tomorrow.
Not going nowhere?
Yeah.
Tomorrow's our last day where we fly back. It's just simply peaceful. Look at that little crab. So I made sure to put on a bug repellent because I guess here they have a lot of sand spiders or hidden mosquitoes, like they like to call them, and they bite. So I've already been bitten a few times, so I'm trying not to get bitten again, but it's probably inedible. I mean, I am sweet like sugar. Hidden under the sand.
the last day of our time here in Puerto Rico. And I will be honest, I had such an amazing time. I thought the Hyatt was amazing. It was clean, it was fun, it had a beautiful atmosphere. I liked everything except for the restaurants. But definitely, if you are in Puerto Rico, you need to journey. Take time to get away from the hotel.
Super cute.
Resort, wherever it is that you're staying, just take time to really have an adventure with the island, with the culture, with the people. Everybody in Puerto Rico was so nice. It's one of my favorite places to be. We've been here before. Last time, I think we stayed for 9 days. This time, the 12 days was perfect because it was an amazing time. And it was like a perfect time, especially flying all the way from California. So I'm just gonna leave you guys with some photos and some scenery of the resort as I close out this vlog. I do want to say thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe. I bring lots of stuff to this channel, not just travel, but also astrology, the chakras, and guided meditations. So thank you everybody for watching. Thanks for watching. Please remember to comment, like, subscribe, and share this vlog out to your friends that are traveling to Puerto Rico. Bye!